European peripheral nations, particularly Greece, it doesn't face a liquidity problem, it faces an insolvency problem, okay? And this may also be true of Portugal, not so Spain. So the large bailout package that was put together by the EC, EU, IMF, and then toss in the ECB and the ECB's agreement to purchase sovereign debt, particularly the peripheral countries, that's a financial backstop. It doesn't resolve the problem. It only buys time. It allowed Greece to avoid rolling over its debt, which it wouldn't have been able to do. It will allow in mid-July, Spain presumably to roll over about $18 billion worth of debt, but it doesn't resolve the problem. Let me tell you, for example, what Greece's problem is. Its debt to GDP is over 100%, okay? Its deficits relative to GDP are double digit, okay? Its market clearing interest rate is far above nominal GDP, okay? Call it a debt death spiral, it faces an insolvency problem, okay? The backstop that was provided does nothing except kick the can down the road, okay? Portugal, similar. Spain has much lower government debt as a percent of GDP, only about 50%. But it has a massive amount of private sector debt. It has, if you look at mortgage and credit card debt in Spain, relative to any denominator you choose, it's higher than in the US. Okay, ditto Ireland. So we face these enormous problems, and one of the crucial points is, how do you enforce a fiscal austerity package? It's even more complex than that. When you consider in the United States in 2008, when the crisis really blossomed, the Federal Reserve and the Treasury made joint statements. We knew that whatever the Fed did, the US Treasury was the financial backstop. Now consider Europe. The ECB buys sovereign debt, so it starts taking into its portfolio Greek debt, et cetera, et cetera. What institution's the financial backstop for the ECB? Well, it's 27 different finance ministries representing 27 different countries. And ultimately, the buck stops in Germany because they're going to end out, you know, paying for about 25% of it. So you see the political kickback in Germany.